FISU is the International University Sports Federation, and it organises competitions in more than 50 sports, and the 3v3 Basketball University League began in 2015, and last year the finals were held on the campus of Huqiao University in Xiamen in China, and the event was so successful that Huqiao University has been honoured with staging the event again in 2017. And the men's semi-final, the first semi-final, is between the University of Kragujevac in Serbia and McGill University in Canada. Two referees, we've got Eugenie Ostrovsky and Zhirong Xi. If you're new to 3-on-3, it's just played into one basket as opposed to the full-size game. Each team has four players, three of whom are on court. And I'll tell you all about the scoring when we have one. You see what we would normally call the three-point line there. If you score inside there, it's 1 point. Outside it, it's two. No three-pointers in this. There's a 12-second shot clock top of your screen there. And the Canadians of McGill University leading 2-0 at the moment. Well, very ambitious two-point shot there, but the rebound, he hit the rim, so that's a new shot clock. And off the ball foul. No limit on individual fouls, but there is a limit on team fouls. Once you get to six, then it's a shooting foul. Well, no foul there, but there was a foul on the rebound. Again, any foul inside the arc, just one shot. And obviously just 1 point. Well, the Serbian side struggling at the moment against the Canadians. I was about to say great shot block, but the foul was called. And McGill University is still leading 2-0. There's an off-balance shot there. It's all hustle and bustle, three against three. If you think refereeing the normal game of basketball, the full five-a-side situation on the front court is tough because there are three referees. I tell you what, refereeing 3-on-3 is extremely tough. It's so quick. And the first two-pointer.
Number 14, Sebastian Beckett.
So the Canadian side in red really are in command at the moment. Those two, that point rather won't count. There was a foul. Nikola Sukov, Filip Popovic and Marko Milakovic for the University of Kragujevac. I have no sub, so it's all about fatigue and pacing themselves for the team in white. And they're their second point. Possession changes as in a normal game on a score. And when possession changes, the team has to bring it back to the outside the arc. No checking required. Well, it was on that occasion. Well, I assume that was a pass. Kragujevac, the left-handed shot goes in. It's 3-4. You see how quickly, on a change of possession, we're back to the action. And rebounded his own shot there, Deli Ogudokun. Of course, the only person who knows for sure whether the shot is going to miss is the shooter. Has a good offensive rebound. And University of McGill McGill University rather back in possession. 3-on-3, of course, will feature in the Tokyo Olympics. There's a holding foul off the ball. First time that 3-on-3 has been in the Olympics in 2020 in Tokyo. That's not to say that the normal basketball won't be there, because he will be there. Americans defending their gold medal they won in London and in Rio. And indeed, in Beijing. The other timing situation in 3-on-3 as well. It's the team that's leading after 10 minutes, or the first team to 21. Well, the Canadians really do raid themselves from outside, and why not? They're leading 6-3 now. Normal rules on defense, you've got to get out to jump shooters, but University of Krajiewicz there, good on the boards. Will that tick up? Bottom of your screen there. It's 4-6. There we go. Another two-point attempt on the shot clock, right on the 12-second mark. 8-4. And the Canadians get the rebound again. And inside, and not quite. Whose possession is that? University of McGill lead 8-4. So 12-8 with about half the game played in this first semi-final. Another two-pointer, and that takes the Serbian side to within three. Krajiewicz this time, their attempt from two-point range, and why not? That's way outside the arc. It's a one-point game. Oh, the foul outside the arc there. But nowhere near the team penalty yet. So it's just a two-point game with 2 minutes remaining in this first semi-final of the 2017 World University League. 3-on-3. The Canadians really do put an awful lot of emphasis on their outside game. Remember, it's the first team to 21 points, or the team that is leading after 10 minutes. Under 100 seconds remaining, surely. Well, a foul on the shooter there, but nothing called. 18-14 now. To Krajiewicz University. The Canadians will not lie down. It's a two-point game again. 75 seconds remaining. Remember, the team that is leading after 10 minutes wins the game. I was about to say there's good defense, but all to no avail. It's a three-point game now. Krajiewicz. Oh, nice pass. That's terrific offense there from the Canadians. University of McGill. Well into the last minute. The two-pointer is up and out. And McGill University get the rebound. Remember, there's a 12-second clock. Shot clock, that is. Krajiewicz get the rebound. Oh, very optimistic. I don't think there's any need to shoot that then. An easy layup. It's a one-point game. And Krajiewicz, of course, you can't just stall the ball. You've only got 12 seconds on the shot clock. And that shot clock is on two. McGill, they fail to get the rebound. Krajiewicz get it. 10 seconds, the two-pointer is up and out. Now, McGill University have got to score to win it. They miss. And there's the final score. Oh, 1 second to go, is there? University of Krajiewicz leading by one. So that's it, 19-18. 19-18. It couldn't have been closer. A 1-point lead there, 1-point win for the University of Krajewicz.
FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.